So to start, I saw a video where you were fighting another goalie in the Islander organization. I've never seen anything like it. Can you kind of talk about how that started?
Yeah, that was kind of a funny situation, but there was a line brawl going on, which that's when everyone on the ice is fighting, and he was kind of waving at me and kind of saying let's go, shaking his gloves at me. And so we met at center ice, and it wasn't much of a fight. I think I threw one punch, and I think he slipped or caught an edge or something and fell, and that was it. It looked cool, but it was a pretty quick little fight, and that was my first one. Then I had another one a few years later that was kind of the same thing, but it was my buddy from my teammate the year before, and yeah, same kind of thing. It was kind of a sumo wrestling match,
Yeah.
but line brawl, and it kind of happens sometimes in the heat of the moment, but it is kind of a rare thing to happen.
Yeah, no, I was cracking up when I saw it. So I want to start off with like first like real like hockey question. So like you were part of like the Blues for your first career start against the Jets. How did you like deal with the nerves of that first start? I feel like I'd be so nervous.
It is an exciting moment. It's obviously the first game you work your whole life for the opportunity to get the chance to play in the NHL. So finally getting the chance to have a start and get in there was very exciting. It kind of happened so fast. I didn't know I was playing until pretty late that night, probably 8 or 9 p.m. the night before. So I didn't really have a whole lot of time to get too anxious. It was just kind of like, okay, here we go. And unfortunately it didn't work out, didn't get the win, but it was great to just get into an NHL game and see what that level's like. And yeah, so I like I was saying, I don't think I really had much time to get really nervous. It just kind of happened so quick, and I just tried to soak up every moment and enjoy it.
Yeah, no, that's a very interesting perspective. I didn't, you know, I don't, you don't think about it. Sometimes it really things come back at you so quick, you don't have time to think.
Yeah, it's
So
almost like if you have more time, you have it's like almost worse if you have so much time to think about it. But when it happens quick like that, it almost kind of forces you to just go with it and try to enjoy the moment.
yeah. So correct me if I'm wrong, but you were part of the Capitals like during their Stanley Cup run, right?
Correct, yeah. Yeah, I
So
was
what
block
was
acing.
it?
I was the third goalie.
Yeah, so what was it like watching that and seeing, you know, your part of your team winning it all and everything?
That was awesome. That was such a cool experience, and to see that group and how close that team was. And there's a lot of good guys in that group, and it was a blast. And just kind of watching that all unfold was pretty cool.
Yeah, so like you've been a part of a number of different teams. What do you think made that team like the most successful? Was there something that you noticed?
I think at the end of the day, that team just loves to play together. Everyone was having so much fun, and it was just like it felt like they just wanted to keep playing forever. And so I think because of that, they just were they knew if they lost, they wouldn't get to keep playing. So I think it was just the amount everyone cared about each other and the amount everyone wanted to play together and was enjoying themselves.
Yeah, so I was just talking a couple of days to ago to some guys like that play for the Cardinals, and they were talking about how like during spring training they really get to lean on like the veterans' advice. So like growing up like and coming up in your career, was there a pro that you leaned on for advice?
I mean, I've had a lot of really good goalie partners and teammates. I think starting in juniors, my second year juniors, every goalie from then on had played pro. And actually in my first year as well, he played in Europe. And you know, I've played with Jordan Binnington, Grubauer, Holtby, Vanacek, Fucali this year is another that I played with this past year that is another great goalie. So I've been really fortunate with my goalie partners, and I feel like I've always been able to kind of learn from them. And you know, just in practice, watching guys that everyone plays a little different, you can learn something from everybody. So I think, you know, just having that kind of being fortunate to play with such good goalies has helped me for sure. And then I've played with guys like Brooks Orpik. I played with him when I was in Washington there, and I thought he was a great leader. He's probably one of the best leaders that I've been around. Just the way he does things, and he cares about all of his teammates, and so he's kind of one that stands out when it comes to leadership for me.
Yeah. So I talked about like, you know, your first career start, but you got to start a lot in the 2018, 19 season. So what were some things during that time you took away and used to like help yourself today? And what was that like experience like getting a lot of reps in the NHL?
Yeah, that was awesome to get that experience. I think it kind of, for me, the takeaway was the importance of consistency at that level. And, you know, every game counts. You can't take any games off. And so I think the lessons I learned from that year were just the importance of making sure every game I'm at my best and doing everything I can to be my best. And yeah, that's kind of my takeaways from that. And also just kind of the difference between the AHL and the NHL. Guys are a little bigger. It's not necessarily, you know, a crazy jump, but just there's little plays that happen in the NHL level that in the AHL level aren't necessarily as smooth or crisp. So just kind of being able to recognize that and know when going from the AHL to the NHL, you have to kind of be ready for things to happen just a little bit more crisp and a little quicker at times.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. So correct me if I'm wrong about this. So you got traded from the Caps to the Blues and then from the Blues back to the Caps. So when that happened, so like, how do they let you know, like you get traded? And do you have like time to say like bye to your teammates? I've never really asked anyone about that.
The first time I got traded is actually a funny story. I was, I'm from Alaska. So I was up there in the summer with my family and we do a trip where we float a river and it's a 4-day float. We pack our stuff on a raft and tents and food and we float for the day, then pull off on the side of the river and camp and float and then camp. And so just a fishing trip where we're gone for 4.5 days. And it just so happened that we had left the morning out of the trade. And obviously out there, there's no cell phone service. Yeah. We don't even take our phones because they're kind of pointless out there. So I didn't have my phone. It happened. We left pretty early in the morning, 4 or 5, and it happened that morning, but I obviously didn't have my phone. And so I didn't know until 5 days later, driving home, we go over a mountain range and then all of a sudden we get cell phone service. And we came over the mountain range and all of a sudden my phone is just blown up. And so I was like, holy cow, something had happened. And so I realized 5 days later, it obviously the GMs and coaches and whatever were calling and stuff. And somehow Mitch Korn had gotten a hold of my mom from our house phone. I don't really know how he got the number. He was with the Capitals at the time. And so he was able to let her know. And she let him know that I'm gone. So I think that was the day after that he was able to get a hold of her. So there was a full day where there was no communication on what was going on. But that was pretty funny. So I wasn't able to say goodbye in person. That one happened in the summer. So I wasn't able to say goodbye to my teammates. But the second time it happened was in February when I was traded back from the Blues to Washington. And that time I was able to say goodbye, and it's tough when you're battling with your teammates all year and then all of a sudden you got to go. But I knew what to expect in Hershey and in Washington's organization, and I had great relationships with a bunch of the guys that I played with were still there and the coaching staff in Hershey. And so I was bummed because obviously I put in a lot of work with that team, with the Wolves, and you know, your mindset is to try and win a championship with the team you're on. It was sad saying goodbye to those guys. That was a really close group and we had a lot of fun that year, but I was excited to get to Hershey and get to work there. And I kind of had a little experience in juniors. I was traded once at the deadline from Tri-City Storm in the USHL to Des Moines. Yeah. And so I kind of had a little experience and knew what to expect. And when I was traded that time, it was very similar situations going from Tri-City to Des Moines. Des Moines was battling for a playoff spot. I think they were just outside of a playoff spot. Same thing when I went to Hershey, they were just outside of a playoff spot. In Des Moines, it didn't work out. We did well for a bit, and then we ultimately stumbled at the end and we didn't make the playoffs. And so in Hershey, the same kind of thing happened. We were battling for a playoff spot and then we kind of started to stumble at the end. And I was fortunate enough to kind of catch myself and say, hey, I've been here before. This doesn't need to happen the same way. It can just it doesn't need to happen that way. So that helped me kind of get my perspective right. And we ended up making the playoffs and had a good little run there. So I think the trades are tough when they happen, especially saying goodbye to teammates and stuff. But it's also another opportunity with another organization to potentially for good things to happen. So there's always good and bad in those situations.
Yeah, I thought it was very cool how you could look back to like your junior hockey experience, you know, and relate it to, you know, what you had to go through in the moment. So you mentioned Hershey. I mean, I've seen videos and the Hershey's like atmosphere looks crazy for like as far as it goes. Like the fan base is awesome there. So how'd like this season go for you? And can you talk a little about that fan base there?
Yeah, this season it was good. We had a good team there. We about halfway through the year we lost a bunch of guys with injuries and call-ups and stuff, so we kind of had to go into battle mode there, and unfortunately we lost in the first round of the playoffs, but we had a good group and we had a hard-working team, and it was a fun group to be a part of for sure. And what was the second part of that question?
Oh, I wanted to ask about like Hershey's atmosphere. I've seen it's like fan base there.
Yeah, it's a fun place to play. It's the fans there are really passionate, and the team has been around so long, there's so much history, and the fans really kind of that kind of gets they're passionate and they expect to win there. So it's a fun place to play, and every night you're playing in front of a lot of fans, and they're all into the game, and it's a great arena, a great setup. So that's a really fun place to play, and I've really enjoyed my time there.
Yeah. So you're going through like free agency right now. You're like the first hockey guy I've got to talk to that's been going through at the moment. So what is that like for you?
It's kind of the first time I've gone through it. I was an unrestricted free agent 5 years ago, but before the end of the season, Washington had kind of let me know they want to re-sign me and had, you know, kind of started that already. So it's kind of the first time as an unrestricted free agent that I've gone through this. So we'll see what it's like. I'm kind of excited to see what happens and what it's all about. So yeah, first timer.
Yeah, no, that's funny. So now that you're in the off season, so what's your off season like for you? Are there some big things that you want to work on right now, or what's that like for you?
Yeah, I mean, there's definitely some stuff I want to work on. As like off the ice, mostly just getting power and flexibility and core strength are what I kind of go mm-hmm. for in the off season. Right now I'm kind of taking a little break and just I have a gym here at my house that I just kind of experiment with, and don't really have too much of a rigid plan for the next week or two, where I'm just kind of messing around, and then I'll start getting more serious about building into next year. But I've tried a couple different methodologies of training where more about power, posture, and flexibility. I've tried functional patterns and Goda the past couple off seasons, and I've kind of combined both of those, and I have a trainer that I work with that kind of helps me combine those, and so yeah, I like to try and experiment with different methodologies and different things to try and get an edge.
Yeah, so when you just said like get an edge, I feel like being a goalie, it's like very mental. How big is like the mental side of that for you in hockey?
Yeah, it's pretty big. I think, I mean, you hear people say it's 90% mental, 10% physical. And so yeah, it's a big part to be able to keep yourself in the present moment and not get caught up in what's happened or what is going to happen. I think staying grounded and in the moment is the biggest thing. So definitely, it's definitely a big part of the game and a part that I think, you know, it's hard to teach that. You have to, it's kind of like inner work you have to do on your own, where, you know, you're able to know yourself enough to know when, you know, you're feeling certain ways, how to keep yourself grounded. So it's definitely something that I strive to get better and better at. And I think the more experience you get, the better you get at understanding yourself and understanding when you may be having negative thoughts or thoughts that may help you. So just, I think it's more of a personal thing. There's mm-hmm. definitely, I know people that can help guide athletes and stuff in that way, but for me, I try and just understand myself as best as possible.
Yeah, no, that makes a lot of sense. Something I wanted to like, we talked about a little bit was like junior hockey. So something I'm very interested in is the college like recruiting in hockey. So you played USHL for a year. Were you committed during that time, or were you doing that to try to get more colleges to like look at you? Can you talk about that a bit?
Yeah, so the USHL is it's the best league in the U.S. to get recruited by colleges out of. So I was fortunate to get the chance to play in the USHL. And pretty much right when you get to the USHL, you get college scouts just kind of reaching out. They want to talk to you. They want to, you know, you to go on visits. So, yeah, like the first, after pretty much the first week of games, there was scouts lined up to talk to pretty much everybody. That's just kind of how that league is, I guess, compared to the North American Hockey League where I was before. I don't know if I had talked to a single college scout, maybe one. And all of a sudden you go to the USHL and they're like lined up to talk to you. So, yeah, that league has just got a good reputation, and obviously a lot of great players come out of that league. So scouts are at those games. And, I committed, I think in November to Michigan Tech. I went on a visit, and it was a really cool school. It's not a huge place, but, it's up in the UP in Michigan. It was a beautiful campus, and Steve Shields was the goalie coach at the time, so I was really excited to get the chance to work with him. I thought that was going to be awesome, and it really helped. He really helped kind of establish my game and helped me kind of simplify it a little bit. And so I think being able to work with him was huge, and that was one of the big reasons why I chose Michigan Tech was because they had a great goalie coach. So, and then obviously, I mean, the school is it's a good engineering school, and I was interested in engineering degree, so. Yeah, it was early in the season in the USHL that I committed there.
Yeah, so we have like a lot of middle school, high school guys that watch this. What would be your like best piece of advice for a guy who, like, wants to play hockey and play college?
I think resiliency is huge. I think, you know, there's all sorts of setbacks that guys go through, and I think being able to just have your eye on the bigger picture. You know, it's easy to say, you know, you get cut or you're not, you know, you're not on the first line or you're not the starting goalie or what have you. You know, it's a longer game. If you're putting in the work every day, then you'll eventually get to where you want to go, but you have to be focused on where you want to go and you have to put in the work. You can't expect anything to be given to you. So for me, looking back, I think, and seeing other guys who I've played with and everything, I think the ones who are the most resilient are the ones who end up, maybe we didn't have the most success when they were younger, but they end up where they want to go because they pushed through the adversity.
Yeah. I wanted to ask one question about your college experience. So at Michigan Tech, what was your favorite experience there?
I think the GLI, which is a tournament around Christmas time, my first year, we won that year, and it was in Detroit. That was a lot of fun. We had a fun team, and obviously getting to win a tournament like that's we were playing in the Joe Louis Arena. That was a lot of fun. And then the following year, the GLI was hosted outside, which is another fun time. We got to play at Comerica Park where the Tigers play, and that was fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say those were probably the two funnest hockey experiences there.
Yeah. I want to get kind of like a few questions that are related to hockey, but more kind of fun. So like, you're like known for like your very cool like goalie mask. So how much of that do you get to design, and like what all goes into like your final product?
I was working with Dave Art for my first 7 years, and he has his own style, and he's obviously really good. He does almost every NHL goalie. And yeah. So he kind of has his own style. I kind of let him just take the reins and do what he does, because I would have input, and he has like his own style. So it's hard to, when an artist has their style, it's hard to, I don't know, change it.
Yeah.
So, I worked with him. He does a good job. And then this year I went to a guy who I had worked with my first year of juniors out of Texas, Bob Howell. He's done a good job. And so I reached out to him, and I wanted a more simple mask this year, where it's just kind of, cause I find the ones that have a lot of art, they're hard to see from far away what exactly is going on. So I just wanted kind of straight lines that would match my pads. And so I reached out to him, and he ended up, he put together a couple of cool masks for me, one for the Bears and one for the Caps, and they came out really well. And it was just what I was looking for, kind of simple, that you could see from far away what's going on, and that would match my pads well. So, he did a good job. That was Robert Howell, and I always put the candy canes on the chin because I'm from North Pole, Alaska, so it's just kind of a little homage there. Some guys like to do like their number or nickname or whatever. But I always, like, the number always changes in pro there, and then all of a sudden it'll be changed if you're called up or whatever. So I never wanted to do the number, and then the nickname, I always thought, like, just a homage to my hometown would be a good thing there.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. That kind of led into my next question. So you talked about being born in North Pole, Alaska. You moved to Ohio and then back to Alaska. Like, you're the first person I've ever talked to from Alaska. So, like, what is life like in Alaska for you when you were growing up?
Yeah, so to kind of piggyback off what you were saying, I when I was 1 year old, I was born in Fairbanks, Alaska. We lived in North Pole. And then when I was one, we moved to outside of Columbus, Ohio. And so I started playing hockey in Columbus. And then when I was seven, we moved back up to North Pole. And so then I was there until I left to play hockey. And so it's a different place to grow up, because North Pole is a small town, but as far as hockey goes, there's not a lot of teams to play against. I think there was three or four teams when I was growing up. So you're playing against the same teams constantly. And then occasionally we'd go out to either California, or I think maybe went to Chicago a couple times. We went to BC. So every now and then we'd go to tournaments, and that was good. But and I didn't really know it was different until I went to go play my last year of U18s. Yeah. I went and played in California, and there were so many different teams we're playing against. It was like, I didn't realize that was how it went. I thought that, you know, I was played against three other teams. And so it was different in that way. Not as many players as if you're in a bigger city or closer to bigger cities. So, we obviously are fortunate enough to be able to skate outside quite a bit up there. And that was, I still love, whenever I get a chance, I always want to skate outside, because it's, I always enjoy that, getting to skate on a pond or a river or lake or whatever. But I actually played with some pretty good players in Alaska growing up. Some of them went and played juniors and a couple college. It was a little different.
Yeah. Is there a place that sticks out as your favorite place to play hockey?
That you traveled to. There's some cool places. Austin, Texas is a cool city that I've enjoyed. I've gone there a few times. Tampa is a cool place. Charlotte, North Carolina is a cool place to play. And then, like, the places that I've played, I think Hershey's a great spot. Just the atmosphere and the towns. The town's a very well kept town, and I enjoyed there a lot. Chicago was a fun place as well. I think I always try and look at the positives no matter where I'm at. So it's hard to, like, pick a favorite, but I think all around, I think Austin, Tampa, and Charlotte are some pretty cool places.
Yeah, no, I always think it's, I always like to ask that one, because you've been, you know, all over the country. So the last question we always finish off with, this one's a hard one. So when your career is over down the line, how do you want to be remembered?
That's a good question. I want to be remembered as a guy who is always, I want to always be trying to do the right things. I always want effort out on the ice. I want to lead by example. And I want to be a good teammate. I want to be someone that guys can rely on, that steady. Yeah, I think those are the things I want to be remembered for.
Yeah. Well, Pheonix, I really appreciate you coming on, man. I wish you the best of luck, and I'll be sure to watch next year and all the seasons come.
Sounds good, man. I appreciate it. Good luck with the tennis.
Thank you.